besides company mentioned, are there other areas that are interesting to venture capitalists that we should be looking at? If therapeutic places, without obviously without tipping your hand too much about what you're looking at, are there therapeutic classes, diseases, platforms that might be something that your burgeoning entrepreneur might want to investigate further?
Actually, I noted a few down before the panel in terms of areas that that we've been looking at over the last year, and again, a number of them have been quite prevalent at this this conference. Biologics, particularly biosimilars, there's been a lot of discussion here about delivery approaches to value-added ways to deliver biosimilars. Similarly, vaccine delivery, particularly through the skin, where you've got a very different immunomodulatory mechanism for introducing an antigen into human novel antibody scaffolds, biologic scaffolds, as discussed on the panel yesterday that Joyce was on. We might throw in other areas such as pain, where we've been quite active over the last year, surgical approaches to weight loss, ophthalmology, and we've been fairly active in molecular diagnostics. So some, those are just some of the areas that we've been looking at.
I mean,
from
what we're seeing in Boston, I think a couple of areas are, people seem to like, you know, it's a big trend about the binary outcome. You know, everybody knows what it's like to build a company and how exciting that is. But for some investors, having a very crisp answer, we have one asset, it's got a binary outcome, and at the end of this phase one or phase two, A, preclinically, we're going to be able to tell whether it worked or didn't work. For some investors, that's very attractive, and we found a great deal of traction. I think the other place that's been very interesting is, if there's a platform that can be exemplified, and you can actually see that that platform sets up almost a set of rules so that you can tell whether you have a drug, whether you can do it again. That's been surprisingly interesting when we've been talking with investors. I've been surprised because sometimes a platform is a dirty word that you don't mention in a tough financing environment, and yet being able to exemplify it has got a lot more traction than I think we've been surprised about.
Well, I'm not a drug delivery expert, so I actually tried to chat with some folks inside of Pfizer who are. And gosh, you won't be surprised to know that they said oral delivery of proteins is a number one hit parade request. But I had also been cautioned to say that that still seems to be the holy grail, which may be very challenging. So some of these alternative ways to deliver biologics without using whole injectables would be a great fully injectable delivery systems, I think, would be a great achievement. Targeted delivery to certain tissues or organs specifically, or maybe even target molecular receptors or other targets inside cells would be, of course, a great risk, a great interest. So I think there are some things within the delivery space that the pharmaceutical industry would be very interested in hearing solutions about.
I guess I'll answer the question a little bit differently in terms of areas that have become more difficult for us, at least. I think primary care, therapeutic areas, therapeutic products in general are more difficult, in part related to the point we were discussing earlier, the total capital required for profitability when you need to field a 500 to 800 person field force is much, much higher. So companies like Reliant, which obviously was extremely successful with the awesome acquired by GSK, I don't know if that company could get funded. That for that reason. That said, there are exceptions to that, and recently we did